Seaside. Yep, we're here in Seaside, Oregon. It's not directly by the sea, but it's within walking distance. And man, is it pretty here. You got Cannon Beach, there's some national parks. I think you got Indian Beach. You go a little further north, you get into Astoria, you cross over into Washington. You catch where a lot of the Goonies scenes were filmed. There's a lot to do here. And so there's your guard shack. That's where you're going to check in. All right. And they actually have a vacancy sign, which is funny. It's lit. It says vacancy, but I've also seen no vacancy when we got here. And you have a choice. You can stay on the north side. I don't believe there's any 50 amp on that side. I'm sorry, the south side, where that car is coming from. You can come down here and stay in the north side. You're going to get you a gate code that will unlock either pad. This one's an unmanned guard shack, and that one is manned, and the staff here is fantastic. So we're going to take a look at the park. We're going to be here for a while, and there's a lot to do outside of the park, but also inside. Right, so you're coming in down the road here, get back to the north side, and see there's a path right here. A lot of people are taking bicycles or even walking, and right through that veg, you can see our Dallas Cowboys colored rig. Tough to see, that's where we are. And basically it's the backside of the North Loop. And you'd have to go all the way around the corner there and past the clubhouse and past the first loop. And that's where you'll find the back part of the campground. So there's the road that feeds north and south. When we first got here, a lot of these sites right along this area were flooded out because of all the rain. You can still see a green bag over there, meaning that site is not for use. And there's a little bit of water here on the other side of the road, and that spilled over into the actual sites. As you can see here, if you're lucky, sometimes you can catch a duck hanging out. But yeah, all that water out there flooded a lot of these sites. But these are the first sites that you'll see. That is a tiny loop right there behind the bathhouse. And then we are on the back side of the North Park, as we'll get to see at the end of the film. Lots of wonderful areas to walk your dogs. And just enjoy the awesome weather. And take in all the scenery around you. All right, your dumpsters, they have recycling here, which is kind of refreshing. And there's your basketball, pickleball, tennis courts, the clubhouse and pool. You can see her up there. This is where you'll want to unhook your vehicle if you're staying on this side, or even really if you needed to unhook here, you could go to the other side as well. But I believe all the 50 amp service is on this side, as the other side only has 30 amp. These are all back ends too, by the way. There's no pull throughs here at this park. And you can see some wonderful hillside living. And the scenery, like I say, is tremendous. The middle of the north side. You're going to find your cabins. There are getaway cabins over by our spot that are larger. These definitely do the trick. Nice decking on some of these. Get your grill and plenty of space, air conditioning as well. So we're standing on a kind of a dog run. Plenty of pet pickup. Getting closer to the clubhouse, but this is kind of what the middle of the campground looks like here. A lot of people kind of mashed together. You can get some more private spots. It's a bathhouse right over there, as you can see, and like the ones inside the rest of the park. There are laundry facilities, but not inside of the little bathhouses. A lot of the bigger rigs are going to stay here. Most of them will, because they're a little bit easier to navigate, but they are tighter. And so we did not elect to get in the middle of all this, as you shall see at the end of the video. and we'll move along. Okay, towards the top of the north side of the park, overflow, you have a nice fire pit area right there with a kids swing set amusement area. Got some nice volleyball going on right here. It's a shot of all that front row of all everyone mashed together. And another one coming in right there. You imagine he'll find a spot right in there. And they got your clubhouse, activities. They do have some fun activities on the weekends, get-togethers, and have a Cinco de Mayo party, taco bar type thing. And there's always things for kids going on the weekends. The other building back there is the indoor pool and hot tub. And all the facilities are well maintained, and the amenities here are really good. All right, there's the swimming pool and the hot tub enclosed, so year round. And then on the back side of that, you got your pickleball courts. It's like full tennis and pickleball. Also basketball. Got a full court down there, future Luca practicing his skills. And on the other side of that is the tent area. All right, this is where you'll tent. Plenty of tent spots. Tent alley ends down there. I've seen tons of people spending an evening or two in a tent or longer, as the weather here is appropriate for that, as opposed to say Texas, where it's probably too hot to tent for more than a few days. But people come out here and do it for long stretches, actually. So this is kind of interesting on the north side. It's not really a dog park because it's kind of like an island. It's gorgeous. I've seen plenty of dogs running around over here. I guess you can unleash and hope that they won't like take off in one of these moats. But you'll see geese and ducks in this part of the property. And the grass here is terrific. Very scenic. Let's see if we can't catch some of our feathered friends. There you go. So I'm getting pulled over here. Won't get pulled into the water. There they all are right there. And it's a terrific piece of property here at Seaside. One of the prettiest parks we've been to. And the dogs absolutely love it. Another one of these little trails Kylie wants to go down right now. It's pretty thick through there. We did it one day. That'll take you to the furthest point from the clubhouse, even past where we're staying. But if you search hard enough, you can find a few of these that you can walk through to get from loop to loop. Another neat little area to walk your dogs in and just hang out. I always like to get over here and get crazy. There's some animal sense. You know, there's elk and deer and stuff that run through here. And so you may run into seeing some of that on your stay. I saw a ton off of 101 on the way to Astoria one day. But I've seen a lot of people just come over here and just take pictures of these trees. And I got another person coming in right there, but there's a deck that you can stand on and just kind of lean in and check out the trees. Nice fresh air, very pretty. So this building here is closed on the south side. As you get past the guard shack, it probably used to be a little clubhouse, and so they're telling you to go to the main clubhouse on the north side. But if you still wanted to hang out here on the deck, you could. And they got some ice for sale. And spots here seem to be, well, it's a little more, a little tight over here, and they seem to be a little bit smaller. But this side has a couple things that are noteworthy, including a dog park. Okay, south side has a very nice restroom, and also the laundry facility is right behind there. Plenty big, plenty of machines. You won't get sized out because there's not enough machines. The building is older than the restroom, but plenty of space to do your laundry. That'd be the first loop you can stay in as you pass the guard shack. You're on the south side with your kids' rec area, and we're making our way to the enclosed dog park down the end of that road. Take a look at that. Good boy. You shake? All right, good boy. Okay, so the south side, it's got a dog park. There's no grass except for that patch right there, which gets used a lot until it's brown out. So this is the back part of the south. This is a straight shot from the guard shack, which was right up there. So you have several loops that you can stay in. This one here, all right, and there's one across the street. And it's all tied together. There's like a loop within a loop. There's an inner loop and an outer loop here. And like I said, pet pickup bags are available just about everywhere. There's not as much vegetation on this side as the side we're staying on. I wouldn't call our side primitive, but there are some spots where it's, you know, there's just more growth. So you come in here and hang out and take a look at stuff like that. Just really pretty. And this is one of our favorite parks for sure, for a number of reasons. Staff, amenities, closeness to lots of things to do, and you have the ocean. Can't beat it. And, of course, we love our dog park. So inside of the south side, this used to be mini golf, you can tell. Except now it's just concrete with holes in it, as Conan is indicating right there. And maybe they're redoing it. I see a little bit of work happening right here. So, no mini putt on this particular trip. So if you remember, the heart of the north side, the cabins and all the people in the middle there, behind the pool and the clubhouse, you take this road right here, you'll find there is another loop back here. And that's where we decided to pop in for a couple weeks. And don't have a neighbor on that side as it's bagged. One of those little nifty little trails that I was telling you about. I'll take you from loop to loop. And across from us is also a bag site, so no neighbor there. And the larger hideaway cabins, which are occupied a lot. They're bigger. Seen some family gatherings here. And we also have, right now, we have no neighbor on that side. So you're talking about a pretty private area right here, for the most part. All right, back of the park here at Seaside, it's your bathhouse. You self-trash, just take it to the dumpsters, they're everywhere. And there are plenty of pet pickup stations for you and your pet. This is the backside of the north, as there are two halves to this park. Very pretty day. And we'll go check out our spot at the rig. So we're leaving tomorrow. But as you can see, this is a full hookup. We did get a 50 amp connection. And we back up to all that vegetation. That main road is right there. And it's a little bumpy over here. There's some moles, but it was a really good site. I've already made the fence smaller. We're going to burn some wood tonight and move on down the road. So definitely recommend Seaside for many reasons. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. Stay safe. Happy travels. We'll catch you next time.
Are you ready?